I was ready to spend the rest of my life with you, Hitomi. But it wasn't me you came back for, was it?
I'm sorry, Alan.
No, don't apologize. You and Vaughn have something between you that reaches across the big empty between the worlds. You would take a bigger fool than me to try to get in the way of that. I guess what I'm trying to say is, can I get some breakup sex?
You know, Alan, someday you're going to make some lucky nymphomaniac very happy.
We tried our best to make this marriage work, but it was never really in the cards for us, was it?
That's not true, Dryden!
Sure it is. What we had was something special, but it wasn't love. Not the way it should be between a husband and wife, anyway.
We can work on it. We can.
They say if you love someone, you should set them free. Princess, you're free.
Okay, I'm sure that's a very nice gesture, but the legal system here really doesn't recognize the concept of divorce. Dryden!
Every man wants you to be his girl, but I'll wait, my dear, till it's my turn.
Alan, you may have heard that Dryden returned my wedding ring and left the country.
But he was next in line to the throne. That means... wait, what does that mean?
With my father's failing health, it's very important to him that we establish a clear line of succession. That's why we agreed that I should ask you...
yeah?
If you would do me the honor...
yeah?
...of informing my sister Ares that she's been named sole heir to the throne of Asteria.
Oh.
Ha ha Haha, you thought you were gonna get some.
Yeah, silly me.
Finally, after 25 episodes of Edge of Your Seat Adventure, we've managed to bring our ultimate weapon to bear in support of our Asturian allies.
About that, sir, the Asturians have asked us not to deploy the alchemy bomb.
What? Is it because they're afraid that destroying the entire Zybok fleet in one fell swoop will be considered a war crime?
No, sir, apparently they think it's kind of a cop-out.
A cop-out?
They're afraid the audience will think that having an allied army that's never been mentioned before suddenly show up out of nowhere with an ultimate weapon that hasn't been foreshadowed is too much like a deus ex machina.
Never been mentioned before? I had to personally infiltrate the Fell Brotherhood to obtain the blueprints! We defeated the 8 god beasts of Ganesh to assemble the crystal shards! We lost poor Cedric and Washburn to the Negromancer's counterattack!
Yes sir, but apparently all that stuff was cut for time.
Cut for time? Oh, for the love of... deploy the alchemy bomb!
But sir, you know what it does? We'd be just as vulnerable as Zybok.
Fine! You're Francis, you're Carol, you're Booster Gold, and I'm General Hard-Ass McBaby Killer! Now deploy!
You were the girl that changed my world. You were the girl for me. You lit the fuse, I stand confused. You were the first.
Lord Delandau, you've been called to the front. The Basram army has deployed the A-bomb.
Basram has the atomic bomb?
No, sir, the alchemy bomb. It's a narrative device that kills all characters without a name to simplify the story before it reaches its conclusion. I myself only survived because my name was revealed to be Jajuka in the last episode.
Wow, if I had known that, I'd never have named you, Toby.
What you doing, Falcon?
I've spent every waking moment they could spare me from the war councils creating my own fate alteration engine.
Like Dornkirk's Atlantis machine?
Not nearly as powerful, I'm afraid. But with only a few months more work, I believe it should be sufficient to teleport me deep into the heart of-
Oh, did you need to go somewhere? I can take you, I'm not doing anything this afternoon.
Wait, you can teleport? Since when?
Since the first episode.
What's your maximum effective range?
Interplanetary. Are you okay?
Just give me a second. Okay, let's go.
Hello? I'm Emperor Dornkirk, I am.
We know who you are.
Oh, hello, Falcon. Come to ask for your old job back, have you? Well, I don't know. Your replacement is a real up-and-comer in the Zyborg military!
Greetings!
Shut up, you!
Please, sir, we've come to ask you to put a stop to this terrible war.
Oh dear, is this a glitch in the Matrix? Because I could swear we've had this conversation before!
But it's caused so much suffering, if only you'd listen to us.
No, you listen! I'm in a really bad mood today on account of I just passed a kidney stone the size of a golf ball. Now when you've done that, you can lecture me all you like about suffering, but not bloody will until...
Olgin, can't you talk to him?
No, no more talk. I'm going to kill him and end this war myself.
Oh, look at the big man with his big sword. Well, come on. Bring it on, bitch. I might be older than Moses, but by God, I can still take you down with me.
Oh, that does it, old man. Give me your best shot. Good shot.
Oh, who couldn't predict an equal and opposite reaction now, bitch?
No. No more killing, no more death. I don't want to live in this world anymore.
I told him what would happen, but he didn't believe me. Oh, ho, ho, Falcon, you stupid son.
Oh my God, you're alive?
No, I'm dead. I told him I'd take him down with me.
You mean you knew this would happen? Then that means this was all...
That's right. Just as planned!